Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be unboxing and checking out the all new Mac Mini. This thing is awesome. Apple gave us new iMacs, new Mac Mini, and new MacBook Pros, all rocking the M4 chip. They upgraded us to 16 gigs of RAM. I've said for years that needed to be a base thing, and they finally did it. Hello, get on board, but yeah, at least they did it, right? So everything now has at least 16 gigs of RAM. That is really cool at the starting point. This particular model of the Mac Mini has 64 gigs of RAM. I've got the M4 Pro in here, and I've got a 1 terabyte hard drive, and that gives me, with the M4 Pro, that unlocks those Thunderbolt 5 ports, which gives us awesome transfer speeds out of those back three USB-C ports. So let's go ahead, let's get this out of the box. I wanna link this up with my Vision Pro. I just got a hold of a few days ago, the all new Vision OS 2.2 beta, I believe it is. And that has the all new ultra wide monitor feature. And I said on the channel ways back, I'd share it with you guys. Well, it's here, let's check it out, but let's put it with the Mac Mini. And let's see what I believe the future of computing is gonna be. And that's gonna be smaller desktops and maybe no screens where we have glasses or VR type stuff that we're putting on and we're able to interact with our computers, but our powerhouse, the machines, you know, that are running a lot of the hard stuff, the intensive stuff are gonna be smaller. And that is awesome. So let's get this out of the box. Let's see what it has inside and do some size comparison. And then we'll hop over to what I think is the desktop of the future. Let's get into the video. We've got a super small box here. I'm going to grab some size comparison things here. So I've got a Raspberry Pi 4 right here. This is in a fairly small case. It's stacked up a little bit. Regular Raspberry Pis, not a little bit smaller, about two of these plastic pieces here, shallower and stuff. But that's gonna give you that. And we've got an Apple TV, one of the newer ones. So kind of give you even just right here, I mean, there's your box and there's your Apple TV. So I already got some ideas that this thing's gonna be small. But really cool, and let's get this out of the box. So as always, I've said it before, say it again, I love Apple's packaging. I love how simplistic it is. They have one of the best presentations, I think, when it comes to packaging on the market, or in the market, I should say. And there it is, ladies and gentlemen, that is the all new Mac Mini. That thing is so tiny. It is a 5x5x2. So to give you a comparison here real quick, there is an Apple TV, I'll stack that right there. And then this is my Raspberry Pi 4. So let's take that out of the equation there. So this is like basically two Raspberry Pis side by side almost, a little bit longer in the front there, and not that much thicker than a Raspberry Pi in a case. So that is amazing. And in comparison to a Raspberry Pi, this thing packs a lot of power. So I cannot wait to get this turned on and check out what's there. But let's go ahead, let's open this up here. We'll take off this awesome protective filming. All right, so there is that. There's the power button. You know, I don't know why we put the power button on the bottom, but we did. Cool, whatever, you know. Honestly, I don't turn off my MacBook Pro that much, so I guess this sitting on a desk, they're not planning on that. We've got our USB-C ports in the front. We've got a 3.5 millimeter audio jack in the front. That is really cool. Your power port. Now, I did not opt for the $100 extra 10 gigabit port, but you can get a 10 gig port on this. That is awesome. My Synology NAS back here has a 10 gig port, and I have a 2.5 gig adapter, but this would be awesome, especially if you've got that kind of setup for storage and data transfer. That is what you want. That's just insane. You've got your regular HDMI port there, and then you have these three Thunderbolt 5 ports. Now, I cannot wait to test these out. I don't even have anything that's Thunderbolt 5, so I probably won't get to fully test them, but that is really cool. So that's what you get there. I haven't even gotten into the rest of the box here. We get a cool black cable here. This is not your standard. Interesting. So with most Mac Minis and Apple TV and stuff, you get that kind of like plasticky cable, power cable, but they've now gone to that braided cable. That is a really nice nice power cable. I'm really happy that they went with this. It doesn't, probably not going to be as sticky over time as a regular cable gets. And I don't know if you've ever had an older power cable like this, but sometimes that material like degrades over time. So really, this is really nice. Really nice, like nylon rope braided cable there. And that is really cool. That is, there's the packaging right there, Ralph. And some, a little bit of instructions there. That's really cool. But besides that, very minimalistic. Apple is definitely taking us down to not a whole lot in the boxes anymore. But let me get this thing set up because I want to check this out with the Vision Pro. Because I think this is the machine for the Vision Pro. MacBooks are cool and they're great for traveling. But this for a home computer should be really, really awesome. And I really want to see what this can do. Because of its size, I can throw this in a backpack. I mean, it's an Apple TV. It's not much bigger than an Apple TV. And that is just nuts. That it's just insane, especially considering this has a terabyte inside. This has an M4 Pro processor in it. It's got, you know, what is it, 64 gigs of RAM. This is just really, really insane. And then again, like my Raspberry Pi, this only has 8 gigs of RAM. So size comparison there, there's 8 gigs of RAM, 64 gigs of RAM, not a very fast processor, a stupid processor. I mean, just really, really cool. So I cannot wait to check it out. Let's get this thing plugged in. Let's get it set up and let's see what this thing can do. All right, so we've got the Mac Mini set up and we've got it on the latest beta. We've got the Vision Pro on the latest beta 2.2, I believe it is. And we are ready to check out the ultra wide display. So let's hop into the headset and let's see if this is really where the future of computing is. Let's do it. So I'm gonna throw on my headset here. We're gonna go ahead, put my battery in my pocket. And as you can see, like right in front of me, I don't know how much you can see from the camera, but we have so much real estate. And look at that Mac, it's so tiny. It is like, it's insane how small that thing is. But look at all this space. I think that we need to add in, I don't know, maybe a giant monitor, because, you know, we don't have a monitor, we have a wall, but what if we could turn our walls into monitors? And we've seen that in Vision Pro. It's not something new, but what is new is what we can now do with the Vision Pro in the virtual display. So let's open up the Mac Mini virtual display here and check that out. I think what we should do is go ahead and open up our virtual display. So let's go ahead, let's click here on our Mac virtual display and look at that. However many Macs you have, they all show up here and you just click on the one you want. I want Ryan's Mac Mini. And just like that, I now have a Mac Mini with a little tiny screen. And we've seen this, it's nothing inherently new, but what is new, and I'm gonna go ahead and close out these apps here just to go ahead and kind of give us a base starting place. So we now have up at the top a new Mac virtual display dropdown. And in that dropdown, we have two new settings. So we have wide, which is the equivalent, I believe, of two 4K monitors side by side. So look at that. That is really cool. I mean, I can push this away from my Mac and I've got a really nice screen over here. I could open up the App Store like I had before. I already got that in quartered view, and it's gonna go ahead and ask questions that I don't want it to. But let's go ahead and do this. Let's do half view, so give you kind of that dual, 4K monitor. You had them side by side. So we'll use Apple's new window management that they gave us in the new Mac OS. I use Magnet on my Macs normally, which is keyboard shortcuts, but this is actually pretty good too, and I really like it, honestly. But there's your two displays, and then let's go ahead and let's check out ultra wide. Let's see ultra wide content here. So let's get a YouTube video up. YouTube ultra wide content. So let's go ahead and get that up. So this is your 21:9 aspect ratio. So let's go ahead and let's go to this fish video here. And apparently we're gonna play a commercial, so I'll let that play and just show you, like, this is massive in and of itself, right? You've now got so much screen real estate to work with that it's insane. But there's your 21:9 aspect ratio. You've got the black bars. It's still not completely formatted, I think, to this ratio. But let me open this up here and look at how big that display is. I mean, I've got my own personal, you know, saltwater aquarium in front of me that is just stupid big. And of course, I can still come in here. I can still open up other apps in my Vision Pro, just like we know we can. So whatever I need to do. So I could open up Bezel over here and I could maybe connect it to a device if I wanted to and, you know, do something like that. I could open up, let's see, I don't know, so many different apps that I can interact with. I could open up a IMAX if I wanted to and throw that over here. So I'll throw IMAX over here. It's so massive, by the way, that I've got to literally turn around and face this camera to get to see this screen. It's that massive. It's just crazy. And I really am trying to be as smooth as I can. I apologize for any shakes and any jitters, but this is just nuts. So let me go ahead and I don't think there's a third, but let me go ahead and like third this here and give you kind of an idea of what the ultra wide display could do with maybe three different apps running. So I'll go ahead and I'll open my calendar. Maybe, you know, you had a calendar and you were, you know, tracking your calendar while you were working online and or doing something. I mean, I've got three apps open at massive size. In fact, actually, this one is probably bigger than it needs to be. So in reality, I said third, but let's just be honest, I could put probably four. Yep, I can put four windows at really, really decent size in this one ultra wide display. And that is just crazy to me. It is a lot better than, let's go back over here to the normal display. This is what just came with the Vision Pro. And it was cool when we had it, but look at what it does to this. It's got everything stacked on top of itself. There's not a lot of room. I mean, there was a decent amount of room. There's how big I could make it. And I could force this and make it work. It was good. And it's when they changed in a Vision OS 2.0, I believe it was, they did the rendering in the actual Mac itself. That changed this drastically. I mean, the quality got so much better. But now with the wide, or even the ultra wide, but I'll go ahead and do the wide. Now this is max width, right? Like I have this stretched out as far as I can go. I mean, look at this. This is just insane. And there's my four apps. I could do two massive apps side by side. I could force these with no problem and have tons of real estate. But where this thing really shines is that ultra wide screen. It's just so gorgeous. And it's so massive. I don't even know, honestly, how to convey this to you because I'm sitting here and maybe the only way, let me turn around here and show you. So there is my monitor. That is a 55-inch monitor. It's a Samsung ultra wide. I say ultra wide, but it's the Arc. So it's a pretty decent big monitor. It's 100 pounds. It's a pain in the butt to move. And look at that. My entire desk is basically gone and I still got to turn to get to the left side of the monitor and turn to get to the right side of the monitor. Now, obviously I can come in here and I can shrink this down, but it's still bigger than my 55-inch monitor. And you know how hard it is to move a 100-pound monitor? It's a pain in the butt. But check this out. Oh, look, I just moved a, I don't know, 110-inch. I don't even know how to quantify how big this is in space. I mean, it's okay. I can quantify it this way. My room is a 10x10 room and in the office, and this goes past that by at least a couple feet. So we're talking at least a 10-foot screen. That's a good way to quantify that. So that kind of gives you maybe an idea of how massive it looks in my vision. Obviously, you know, it's not, but it's so much simpler to move that. And I have so many different abilities with this to be able to interact with my content. And I have to say, Mac Mini right there, ultra wide display right here, filling up my entire office, and then the ability to use the Vision Pro like it's meant to be used, which is other apps running, and still have all of that content available to me, is just amazing. So I really think that this is where computing is going, because a 100-pound monitor or, you know, a headset that in the future will be smaller than this, lighter than this, but maybe with the power of the Mac Mini, it's so cool. Honestly, if you get the chance to check it out, if you have a friend that has a Vision Pro, go hit them up, check out the new Ultra Wide. You do have to be on the beta, but it's coming out in December, I believe, for everybody, all Vision Pro owners. So if you've got a Vision Pro, you can go out and download it in December, and you'll have the new ultra wide desktop and the regular wide, and it's really, really cool. And I really, really love this. So I hope this has been kind of a good overview of what you can do with a Vision Pro and a, you know, Mac Mini. And honestly, the price difference between that monitor and this headset is not that far off, and this is way more usable and way more portable. And honestly, I could throw my Mac Mini and this in a backpack, and I've got a really awesome editing and, you know, coding and just insanely powerful computer. So I'm going to go ahead and continue testing this thing, and I will put some local models on this and probably use it this way, honestly, to test the local models, because this is amazing. And I really love working this way. And with the strap setup I got here, I barely even feel the weight of the headset. So yeah, this is just awesome. All right, so that has been my unboxing and initial review of the Mac Mini M4 Pro using the Vision Pro with the all-new ultra-wide display. And if you're interested in that and you have a Vision Pro, you can download the beta software. You do have to be on the newest beta for both of these devices, both macOS and VisionOS. I believe it's 2.2 over here and 15.2 over here. I could be wrong on that. If I am, I'll throw it up at the bottom of what they actually are. But you do have to be on those. Those, however, will be out for everyone if you don't want to use beta software on your stuff. That will be out for everyone, I believe, in December. Don't quote me on that. I don't like have an inside track, but I have heard rumors that that's coming in December. So look for that. The ultra-wide display with this Mac Mini is an amazing desktop setup. It's an amazing just work setup. And imagine the fact that that's in your office. Like, I pinned that over there. Now I could go around my home from a decent distance, right? And as long as my keyboard and my mouse can get to my Mac, I can almost work anywhere. So it's really, really cool. I really like where the technology is going. I love the size of this thing. And I really believe that when this and this kind of meet in the middle, we're gonna have something amazing, because this form factor and this much horsepower in a device like this is gonna be incredible. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like, comment, subscribe, share, and we will see you in the next video.